Dear participants, welcome back in the afternoon session of today's FDP come STTP. We are sorry for some technical glitch. Because of that, 5 to 10 minutes delay was arises. So I welcome you all in this fifth lecture that is entitled with modeling and modeling approaches in tunnel field effect transistors. And this lecture will be delivered by Dr. Suman Kumar Mitra. So prior to the start of the lecture, let me give the brief introduction of Dr. Suman Kumar Mitra. Dr. Suman Kumar Mitra, member IEEE, is an assistant professor in the Department of Electronics Engineering, Harcourt Butler Technical University, Kanpur. Dr. Mitra received his doctoral degree from NIT Silchar, India. Currently, he is with the Department of Electronics Engineering. His current research interests include simulation and modeling of MOS devices application as a biosensor. He has published several journals in reputed international journals like Microelectronics Reliability, IET Micro and Nano Letters, Journal of Computational Electronics, Springer. He is a reviewer of several reputed journals like IEEE Transaction, IEEE Transaction on Ultrasonics, Ferroelectrics and Frequency Control, Solid State Electronics, IET Journal Letters, Elsevier Journal and Springer Journal. So with this brief introduction, I am requesting the respected speaker, Dr. S.K. Mitra, to deliver his topic. Dr. S.K. Mitra.
Thank you, Dr. Manishima, sir. And I welcome all the participants to the second day afternoon session. So my as per described by the Dr. Manish Kumar Singh, my topic will be modeling approaches in TFET. So in morning session you have already I think So in morning session, I think you have already gone through the modeling approaches in FinFET, fin field effect transistor. Fin field effect transistor. So here we'll see the modeling approaches of tunnel field effect transistor, or shortly said it is the TFET. So yesterday also in the afternoon session by the Dr. Rajesh Saha from NIT Jaipur, he also given the brief introduction and the working process of the tunnel field effect transistor. So I will not spare much time on the introductory part. So we'll directly go to the modeling approaches of TFET. So as you already know, my PPT outline will be first introduction, and then some we'll discuss about some gate engineering aspect of the tunnel field effect transistor. Then we'll see that how one back gate effect, and then we'll see the three modeling approaches. As we already know that tunnel field effect transistor is consist of PIN structure, P plus I and N. It can be work on N type and P type, both sides, both mode. PPT is visible to everyone.
Suman sir, it's multiple
windows are opening, sir.
Yeah, multiple screen is visible. You should actually take it as a one link, Suman sir.
So outline I have already told you the introduction, then the gate engineering aspect of tunnel field transistor, then we'll see the back gate and the modeling approaches of in the tunnel field transistor. So You already know that transient effect transistors configuration is PIN structure. So it can be work in N-type and P-type mode both. So here we use carrier as a electron and hole both. So when we are modeling this tunnel field effect transistor, the almost similar to the FinFET yeah, normal MOSFET modeling process only, but main difference is that here the tunneling is occur so current conduction is occurring due to the tunneling mechanism. Means we have drift diffusion and tunneling, three type of basic transport mechanism of electrons. So here we'll mainly concentrate on the tunneling of the electron, and the tunneling happens normally if we consider the N-type, where P plus region is a source and N plus region is a drain. Then it transfer the it tunnel the electron from valence band of the source side to the conduction band of the challenge side as we increase the potential. So the main phenomenon is that when we increase the gate potential, then when we increase the Okay, I think it is in full screen mode now. Okay, so when we apply the gate voltage, then our band got suppressed at the channel or below the gate region, and the tunneling barrier, which is denoted by the red color arrows, the tunneling barrier at the source channel junction is reduced, and the electron got transferred. So this phenomenon we need to implement in mathematical form in our equation. That is the main objective. So now you know the conventional already you see that see this conventional structure. This is a basic PIN structure and basic tunnel field conventional structure. And this almost the modeling of this is almost about near about look like the FinFET structure also, whichever you already discussed by the Dr. Saha. So what I took for my presentation, I took some gate engineering aspect. If you have the gate engineering part also along, we'll discuss the dedicatedly for TFET also. And if we have gate engineering, how we can tackle this gate engineering aspect in our model, that part also we'll include in our presentation. So gate engineering means you can modify your gate length, your gate material, your gate dielectric thickness, and spacer. All other things. So here I taken only two basic things where we are using underlap and overlap, and that is also for some reasons. Actually, in tunnel FET, if you already talked by Dr. Sunil from Intel, he already told informed you in his speech that ambipolarity current, ambipolar current is a great concern in tunnel field effect transistor. So tunnel field effect transistor, if you want to reduce the ambipolar current, then a great opportunity is by using the gate drain underlap concept in the tunnel field effect transistor. Another concept problem is tunnel field transistor, what is also discussed by Rajesh Saha and Dr. Rupam Goswami in the first day, that in tunnel field effect transistor, the on current of the tunnel field transistor is quite low. So if we want to improve that on current, then we need to have some what is called some gate engineering or heterojunction kind of thing or double gate, something like that to improve the on current as it is quite low as compared to the MOSFET. So that part we have done the gate engineering. We have used the gate source overlap portion. So in this way, so these two gate engineering aspect we are going to introduce in our modeling aspect. So this is a conventional TFET only, conventional SOI TFET, where all the dimensions are given in the figure, 30 nanometer source, 40 nanometer channel, for 30 nanometer drain, and total 100 nanometer is your device length. So here, initially we have a hetero gate stack, okay, hetero stack gate, hetero dielectric stack gate is there, and your underlap, 15 nanometer of underlap is there. So here 15 nanometer of underlap is there, and as we going to the advancement of the structure, so first we are increasing, try to increase the on-off current ratio by changing this by changing this gate source overlap portion. So when we change the gate source overlap, then it should increase the on current. How and we see that the on current, when we are increasing the overlap length from 0 to 14 nanometer, then its on current is increasing by small amount, but it is increasing. Later all the other parameters almost it's look like stable, so, or it will look like the suitable one. Then if we check that the reason behind this, that when we increase the gate overlap length, when we increase the gate source overlap length, then the band bending at the source region is increasing, which effectively increase the tunneling area. The tunneling area is increasing, as you see in the inspect or zoom figure. So the tunneling area leads to the increase of the tunneling probability, and that tunneling increase of the tunneling probability means the increment of the tunneling current. That is the main current in the tunneling field effect transistor. Okay. Now, for the ambipolar current, we already have some gate and underlap. But if we increase it, then we'll see that the ambipolar current is significantly reducing for our NATFET devices and for this device also, SYTFET. And the reason is that the tunneling width, our intended reason of operation is source channel tunneling junction, where that is in the what is the previous diagram we saw, this one, this is for the on current part, means at the highest gate voltage, and this is that this diagram, this energy band diagram, it is in the off current part, means we are taking at the minus negative minus 1 volt. So it is not in this, if it is a n-type defect, so ideally it should not work, or it should pass as low as much current possible. Okay, but here what we found, as we reduce our drain gate voltage, the drain current is again increasing. So that should not be happen. But that should be as low as minimum, because the increasing of this current means that will lead to the increment of low standby power dissipation of the device. So we can connect this if we give an example, in our when we are mobile, we are not using our mobile or electric gadget, there is also a power drainage. Yes, battery power, total battery percentage becomes from 70 to 60% or something like that. So that dissipation is low power dissipation, low power standby dissipation. When your device is standby, but your power is dissipating, your battery storage is reducing. So this effect should be reduced. So by underlap, we see that effect is reduced by very much great extent. So these two effects can be achieved by the gate engineering only. Okay. So if we, when we are taking the modeling, so we have to think about different aspects also, because there is a temperature is a great main parameter which affects the device performance. If we see that if we increase the temperature, the band gap narrowing is happening, and which follows this equation, okay, where EG0 is the band gap of any material at 0 Kelvin. So when we increasing the temperature, the band gap narrowing is happening. If band gap narrowing is happening, means that effectively affect that minimum tunneling length, that minimum tunneling length what is available here, that will affect by this. Okay, and If we see about the capacitance of also, and if you remember that Dr. Rupam Goswami also said that capacitance is quite a problem when we prepare a device or we simulate a device, we model a device, we need or we vision that that device will be used for any circuitry, means which will be used in the mobile, computer, or any other electronic gadget. So there, how much if capacitance will be high, that speed of the device will be reduced first. Then power depletion, dynamic power depletion, when you are using the dynamic power depletion will be increased. So the overall power should be less. And particularly when you are using digital gadgets, where our digital logics are used. Suppose a AND gate, NAND gate, NOT gate is or inverter, digital inverter is what is called means manufactured using this MOSFET or TFET or FinFET. Then the CGD is the one of the key component of the which will be affect in the device performance in the and least to the circuit performance also. That CGD actually increase or decrease the Miller capacitance. Miller capacitance means there is a feedback path from output to input. That feedback path actually performs the gain and all other things of the device. So that CGD should be as low as possible. Okay. So earlier in the conventional TFET, it is found that CGD is quite high. But in this gate engineering TFET, it is found that the CGD is become quite low as compared to CGS and CGD. You see that from the left side of the your graph, CGG and CGS is near about 400 to 420, 410 attofarad. Atto means 10 to the power minus 18. And your CGD is found about 1, 2, 3, 4 attofarad. So it's quite low. So it's also good. You can achieve this one using the gate engineering only. So now these aspects we will introduce our in our modeling aspect. So and another thing we are talking about the back gate. The back gate also it is important to improve control the performance. How it's conventionally seen that if back gate voltage is zero, then it's giving the maximum or optimum result for this device. But if we see that non-conventional type where trap fixed surcharge present in the oxide semiconductor interface or fixed oxide charges inside the oxide, then it is found that suppose if you see that when the interface traps are present, that the electric currents are degraded so much, where it the presence of elect traps, the location of presence of electron interface traps also determine the which portion of the current will be degraded. If it is present in the front gate, then it will be degraded the on part. If it is present in the box semiconductor interface, then it is degrade the emipolar part mainly, because it mainly hamper the channel drain junction and the front gate interface mainly affect the source channel junction. That's why it's the on and off current part. It is mainly affected by the trap resistor. But that thing also similar type. Okay. Now main thing is that when we use the back gate, then we say that this is the ambipolar current. You say this is the ambipolar current. We say that the ambipolar current is increasing due to the presence of the trap. But this ambipolar current can be reduced by using the back gate, proper back gate voltage. You see, suppose 1 into 10 to the power 13, if you add zero back gate voltage, then it will be near about like that, 10 to the power, almost 10 to the power 12, or in between 10 to the power 12 to 10 to the power 13 ampere per micrometer current is there. But if we see if it is nearby 0.9 or 0.8, then we get the minimum current. It is near about almost 10 to the power minus 15, or 10 to the power minus 15 or 10 to the power minus 14. So it is two order of difference is there if we change the our back gate voltage. So it's give a extra hand extra controlling capability of your device performance, which is lead to the circuit performances. So These are the effect. These are the concepts we need. We'll incorporate in our models. That is, first is our bed gapping. Sorry, gate length engineering for increasing the on current, off current, reducing the off current, reducing the ambipolar current, reducing the gate capacitance, and back gate. Suppose back gate for controlling the adverse effect by the due to the presence of the trap or fixed structure charges in the devices, and the temperature effect. But in our analytical model, temperature effect can be directly incorporated in our band when we calculate the electronic energy band calculation of the device. So that part we have not included here. That by default, in the throughout the calculation, it is in the 300 Kelvin presumption rate. So before starting that, we are just give you the brief idea of the modeling steps, how the modeling can be done, or what we need to from which point we need to start, and on how will we go one by one. So first step is that if you want to find anything in your device, then you need to find surface potential. First step is you need to find the surface potential. Because without surface potential, you can't find actually any nothing like current, VT, nothing even find. So first is that, or surface potential, or the potential in the device, you need to. Then from that you can. This is the most first I will discuss the most conventional modeling as process in any devices. That surface potential, then you find the electric field. From the electric field, you will find the generation rate of how much generation is taking place. And from the generation rate, you will find the drain current. This is the most conventional or most prominent or most robust way to doing your device modeling. Go to the first surface potential, electric field, generation rate, and drain current. Simplest. But there is later days, it is also found that there's an alternative way also. Calculate the direct current where you don't want to calculate your electric field or generation rate mainly, because electric field in its circulation not that much important inside the mainly depends on the how much current, how much output resistance are there. That is the important parameter. So and we'll also discuss about the some capacitance model also. So if you start from surface potential, there's an alternative way that you can calculate the energy band from the surface potential. And from that energy band, you can calculate for the, that is particularly for the, where the tunneling mechanism, this is I'm saying, the blue color portion is the predefined for the almost all of the devices. Both is the most robust process for the, all the devices. But that the, some specific devices, like where the T-FET or tunnel diode, where the tunneling is main conduction mechanism, in that devices, you can go portion also. Energy band, the minimum and maximum tunneling. What is the minimum and maximum tunneling length, we will also discuss. Then you need to find out the electric field maximum, and then the generation max. It will be generation rate max, and from the generation rate max, direct current. What is the main advantage is that calculating the surface electric field from the surface potential, it is a tedious job, and it's a very long process. So I will we bypass this one and we'll use the right side of thing. Next, from surface potential, what we can find out, we can find out the capacitance, we can find out the threshold voltage of the device. We can find out the noise, we can do the noise analysis of device. So if we see that all this process and all other also there, in this all this process, the surface potential is the main key parameter. So surface first, we need to find out the surface potential. If you already found out the surface potential, means that means almost a basic foundation of your modeling has been done. Here we discussed two geometry. This is a full gate geometry where this whole portion is a source. Here, from this portion to this highlighted region is a source. this is channel and this portion is drain. Here also this portion is drain. Do you see the difference here? Here we have the gate, we have the drain, we have the source, and there is these two regions we actually divided for the depletion region where the tunneling will occur. So depletion region, some share the source part and some portion of the depletion region present in the channel part. So 1 and 2 is the mainly depletion region, and 3 is the channel where depletion region is not there, and 4 is the drain region part where the gate fringing field effect is there. So we have divided into the 4 sections. Now if we see the gate modulated structure, then we see that there is a section where our gate overlap is there, and some depletion region is also there. A portion where the source fringing field effect will be there, a portion where channel side gate fringing field effect is there. This is the depletion region part, and this is the no depletion region part. And due to the drain effect, there is a depletion region also in the source drain region. So we have considered that also, because there are also some bend bending or the changing in the surface potential is present. So in that way, you have to analyze. The first step is to analyze your structure and segregate the region where you have find the uniform effect of the gate or drain voltage in your region. Okay. Now, if we see next, so we'll mainly discuss about the in this way. First, we'll discuss about the GUSD effect, and later part in the another modeling, we'll discuss about the full gate also. So this is the pre-assumption: there are no mobile charges, no trap charges, no mobile charges. Doping concentrations are uniform. No gate leakage current, and source channel depletion region do not process any kind of mobile charges. So these are the pre-assumption of that. If you incorporate that, then it will become a compact modeling. Why compact modeling and normal analytical modeling is different is that compact modeling means when you are done a compact modeling, it is universal. You'll have to give the all the parameters, all the possible parameters. Either it will be the zero or you can give a value. And in analytical model, we take only the basic device parameters and we formulate a drain current of this. No. For the surface potential calculation, as already I think or discussed by the Dr. Rajesh Shaha also, there's a conventional way to use the 2D potential equation. Surface potential, for calculating the surface potential, the two famous physics equation can be used. One is the Poisson equation, and that is the Schrödinger equation. And your device, if it is this device is 40 nanometer long, the channel length. And if your device channel length is near about 10, 14, then you need to consider the Schrödinger equation. That's the quantum effects will be coming to picture. And if your device is more than 14 nanometer, but it is less than 20 or 18 nanometer, then you or 24, 13, 13 nanometer also, 13 nanometer, I'll not say, it will near about 24, then you can take that quantum correction along with the Poisson. You can use the quantum correction model. There is some called Schrödinger based quantum correction models also there. So some people do all the derivation using the Poisson equation, and they incorporate the quantum correction model in this to get the proper result. So as already discussed by the Rajesh Shah, here also we use the 2-3 Poisson equation, and where gate and drain effect is there, where only drain effect is there. In this two region, we discussed that the gate fringing field effect is present up to 4 number region. So 5 and 6, no gate effect we are assumed. So it is only drain effect is there. So that's why we have considered there only one-dimensional Poisson equation. Okay, now the parabolic approximation, that is the standard way of solving. Now after that, we need to formulate the boundary condition. Because we have the parabolic approximation, we have the Poisson equation. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible, sir.
Okay. So now we have to formulate the boundary condition, the left side boundary. What will be the if you we are mainly deriving a Poisson. Okay. Right. Poisson equation for this point to up. Starting from this point to ending at this point. So what will be the boundary condition at this? What is the boundary condition of this location? What will be the top side boundary condition? What is the bottom side boundary condition? Means we'll set the boundary first. Okay, so if you see that this is a box, we will set the all the boundaries of that. Boundaries in terms of potential, maybe in terms of electric field, maybe it's up to you. So by equating the both side electric field, we find the normally boundary condition. So here the bound, if we take the Poisson equation, so we put the x is equal to x, y is equal to 0, then we'll get some value. So here x is in the lateral direction. You see that x. Sorry. So x in the lateral direction and y in the vertical direction. Okay. So x in the so we can put a for the surface y is equal to 0, then we will find the xy means from this parabolic equation you will find this one, and if you put a TS means full thickness at the bottom of the channel, you will find this one. And in this way, the electric field also be considered for the at y is equal to 0 and y is equal to TS. So by using this, and this is the vertical, this is the top and bottom boundary conditions, and this is the left and right boundary conditions according to this. And by using this boundary condition, if we solve this Poisson equation, okay, so it's only PD as the second order partial differential equation solution. If you do that and use this boundary condition, then you will find almost look like it will look like this, and you will find this value, because if this is the that one where PI will be this one and KI will be this one. In this way, in your devices, each every calculation someone takes some consideration, so it may be look like too different to you in every paper. So if you see in the online the 100 modeling papers, 90 to 95% papers you will find this kind of modeling. Okay, this is the most general way of modeling of any semiconductor devices. A solution of the second order partial differential equation for this one, and if you use the one dimensional Poisson equation, this will be this one. And in this process, we have also calculated, because here we have in the second thing. What happened if SY and that baguette is there? So we have used the below side, means at the bottom means dead point, that box and semiconductor interface. We have formulated that this will be the electric field can calculate in this way. But if it is baguette is not there, in the most papers it represented by zero only. Okay, so it will be most easy. But as we have considered that one, so the back gate, that backside box semiconductor interface, the potential we have calculated. So this calculation helps to when we do the that one inter if we include our in our modeling trap and something effect, then we can see that how the back gate voltage can control our current through the modeling also. So that's why this equation is so much important in this modeling technique. So that when you have found out your surface potential, your back gate surface potential, then using the surface back gate potential, then using the surface potential you can find out the energy band gap. When you have already have this surface potential, that means you can use directly EC from here. Okay, and when you know the EC, the you can find out the EV using the material energy band gap, effective band gap. And effective band gap you can calculate it by actually in our simulation, band gap narrowing is also embedded when we use the doping concentration, high doping concentration, that actually band gap narrowing effect is there. So to incorporate this, we have used the band gap narrowing also. And the the band gap to equally distribute the band gap narrowing in the EC and EV part, we have used this phi sigma as a 0.05. So it will equally distribute this band gap narrowing in the both side. So this is the after that we see that the bandgap what I found that is look like almost this one. Okay, now in later part we'll discuss the what is the difference between full gate and this GUSAT FET bandgap and what is the what is called problems or challenges to solve this type of devices. Current or find the current model for this type of devices, that's the difficulties in there. So if we look into this, there is a full gate present over channel. Here is a small portion of gate only present over channel. So due to that, only gate effects is present over here because gate is almost ended over here. Okay, so that portion is gate is ended. So gate is present over here only. So all the later part of the channel, that is almost later for the rest is the channel. So there is no gate influence, is there only drain. So electron, when it's tunnel from this to there, and it need to travel from overcome this hump, or you can say that local maxima is there is a particular term which research used by the research fraternity, the local minima and local maxima. What is the local minima? What is the local maxima? You see that it is a conventional full gate energy band diagram where it's a normal no conduction and the no tunneling is there. When the tunneling is there, there if we see that this is the minimum, sorry, so this is the minimum tunneling length will be found there, and maximum tunneling length and maximum length need to overcome to if a electron want to tunnel from source to drain, or the source to channel or source to drain side, then it need to maximum tunneling length is here and minimum tunneling length is here. Okay, so there is a possibility after that when it there, it just need to drift smoothly and go to, and it will reach the drain end. But same thing is not present here. Here what is happening, if electron tunneling from this local minima position, means there is a local minima is there. This is not the absolute minima, this is the absolute minima. So there is a local minima concept. When electron tunnel from this to this local minima, and that local minima after that local HB present in the after the getting there, in the electron need to overcome that hump and then come to the drain side. So there is another barrier is there, this another barrier is there. So that's why the conventional modeling process will not be affected when, or will not be considered, or you can't take the direct modeling process when you are means using high gate drain underlap in your devices. So what is the solution? So solution is the alternative way. You have found out the surface potential, you have found out the energy band. Now you have to find out the drain current. So drain current, you see, remember we have discussed that from surface potential we'll go to the energy band, the alternative way, energy band to generation rate, and generation rate to we'll find the our drain current. So drain current can be found in this way. So this drain current can be calculated in this way. This is the oil established form, and you it mainly that you find out the generation rate, you will find out the your maximum and minimum current that way. So this is the process for the full gate, where the you find out the average maximum average electric field using the minimum tunneling length, and then this maximum generation rate using that current equation you can use. And how to derive that current equation, you need to find out the generation rate, and generation rate you need to integrate from minimum to maximum your tunneling width, and then you will find out the maximum minimum tunneling will be the minimum bearing the maximum current, and then you will finally find out this equation. Okay, I have not derived that whole thing. I will give you the link of the paper if you interested in seeing this what is called this kind of derivation. So there now that local that minimum and maximum tunneling length is present over here, but there is a problem in the when we use the large gate drain. What is the problem? Problem is that if you see that when we are increasing gate voltage from 0 to 1.2, there is a it is not present, it's not overlapping. Okay, so suddenly there is a minimum tunneling minima is there. okay, before the tunneling minima is not there, but tunneling maxima is almost W2, sorry, it will be W2 minima or maxima, whatever is said. If it is, you should see that in the, it is when it is 1.2, it certainly minimum will be very less. But before that, even in the 0.9 volt also, the tunneling minimum or maxima will be similar one, and it will be very high. So if we consider this, if we embrace the previous concept here, then we will see that sudden spike in the at after 9 volt in the current. Okay, but this is not happening in device. So how to tackle that issue? So there we found out that we'll do that one, but the generation rate calculation, we do it different way. In place of that, the generation rate we have calculated, you will see there is a del phi. Del phi you have already explained by the different figures. So del phi, here we have taken the difference of the band bending. When band bending means psi c and psi zero. Psi c means here, if you okay, if you see that c position means where your gate is ending, and zero position means where gate is your starting. Means in your this Venn diagram, this is at zero, and c means that portion, that location will be your c. So that is will be the total difference. This value is the total difference, that is equal to your del phi. So this del phi actually leads to the your generation rate calculation, and it is found that by if we modulate in this way, it gives a good result, almost matching result. And in this way, when you do the device modification, every time you need to change the conventional way of doing your modeling process. Every basic thing will be same, but you need to do something different for your devices. Okay, so in this conventional, it is one of the most conventional way for the TFET modeling. From that you can draw the green current model, and if you see the result, the surface potential result, this is the box interface potential result, this is the drain current result, and you will find that you see that this is the modeling and almost good matching is there. Okay, now here we found that when we are doing this, we have to do it very rigorously for the our all the different devices. Now the in that process, we have what we have seen, we have seen that from surface potential we have to calculate the energy band, energy band, the generation rate, and energy band up to that is the almost similar, but when we calculate the generation rate, that time we need to consider for our device differently. So solution of this problem, we have we can use another modeling technique for the tunneling device only. The Landier formula based. Landier formula, if you everyone knows, that is a normally use the Fermi Dirac distribution, and finally you give the drain current from the Fermi Dirac distribution. So we use the same concept here. Sorry. So here, first we need to formulate the surface potential, and from the surface potential we need to find out the drain current. So that is fixed. Now the middle process will do it differently. How we'll do it? Now from surface potential we'll pass the energy band, that process is also same, if you say. Now from that process we'll not calculate the generation rate, we'll directly calculate the tunneling probability, because generation rate is good process, but I feel that tunneling, calculating the tunneling probability, because it is a tunneling current, if you once calculate the tunneling probability, then you can find out the exact more precise value for your tunneling devices. So go to the tunneling probability, and then from that you use a Fermi Dirac distribution, and Fermi Dirac distribution to use the Landier formula to calculate the drain current using the Fermi Dirac distribution. It's a simple but a little bit of hands-on for calculation or modification aspect. It's very simple model, but if you do the numerical by in hand and paper based derivation, it will be a little bit lengthy as compared to the previous one. Previous one, the mental stress is much more high. Here mental stress is less, but handwritten work is little bit more. So same assumption, This is the full git, and this is the two-day schematic processes, as we have already discussed. Same way, we have calculated the surface potential for the full git. Okay, now full git for the same process. Now you see that in the full git, we have considered the four region where all the regions, the gate outer fringing field will control here and here. So all these four region will be have the effect of drain voltage and gate voltage also. So all the four region has been considered in that one 2D potential equation only, because gate and drain effect is there. Okay, so similarly, we have done the two-step position equation derivation. UACT, this is for UACT effect, where 1, 2, 4 is for 2D and 5 to 6 is 1D, as we have already discussed. Now, similarly, using the boundary condition, surface potential has been derived for the both the full gate and as well as the that one UACT effect. Okay, now similar thing. After band gap narrowing and all the whatever it is, energy band gap calculation, like the previous one, we need to calculate here tunneling probability. Now, tunneling probability is the this is the one simplest way of explaining the tunneling probability. Find out by different researcher. So there, you will see that tunneling probability, if you integrate from x, e means the minimum to maximum, where is the tunneling probability can go. So maximum, you can find the tunneling probability at the, so where the tunneling length is minimum, and you will find the tunneling probability minimum where the tunneling length is maximum. So it will integrate from minimum to maximum, and you will find out the approximated tunneling probability of the device, average tunneling probability of the device. And there, the tunneling max, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. Okay. So that there, tunneling probe, the maximum current equation can be calculated in this way. This is also found from already put in some papers. How can you calculate? So this is very easy for calculating for the full gate, because it's a conventional way that when your device increase the drain current, drain potential, then your tunneling length will increase gradually. Okay, but in the GOSCT effect, that thing is not gradually, as we already discussed that this thing, tunneling length, when we discuss about the tunneling, then this is the great problem. Then what we use here, we use the corresponding distance to be fixed, that whatever is the tunneling length, because we can see from here that we can't go electron or let me change the ink color. Yes. A electron can grow from here to here, obviously. Okay. It means tunneling length, barrier length, maximum 5 to 6 nanometer or 10 nanometer wide. So electron can, if there is a current is there, electron can travel from here to here. It can be possible. So we have fixed that tunneling length here. Okay. So that is also a consideration for the tunneling. If you are using the high gate on the left, we only use the where the gate end, that position, that's all. That is your maximum tunneling length or minimum tunneling, whatever it is. So you can use that local minimum portion as a maximum tunneling length. And you change that one to, previously we used maximum tunneling length. Here you use C. C is the maximum tunneling length for our case. And rest of the all the derivation is for same for this devices. Now, what after the getting the tunneling current, sorry, tunneling probability, we use the Fermi derivative. This is the Lander formula, and this will used for the drain current calculation. So what we have used, we this is an approximated current drain current equation, but finally using some fitting parameter, we will find the exact current equation. So for full gate, this is will be the your values. And for UACT effect, WT maximum will be replaced by the x equal to c. And in this, using this Fermi Dirac distribution, this two drain current equation can be find out. How? This ID, PT into FS into E, one, and PT into FCH into DE. So two different equations. So it can be approximately this equation can be written as this equation can be written as this. Okay, and finally we have to find out this and this. So this I1 and I2. And if we find out, I want to find out I1 and I2 and put this parameter equation in there, in these two, then we'll see that this I1 and I2 can be represent, this minus means I1 minus I2 summation ID equal to summation of I1 minus I2. So it will be represent in 1, 2, 3. Again, this one will represent 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So each I1 is representing in terms of A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. And this 3, 3 represent two terms. And in this way, you, when you will derive that one, you will see that each term have the small portion and it can be divided into three portion and you will find the small, small result. So it will not the mental task, it will the hand and written task. So each equation is like I3 can be directly represent in this way. And you know that if you put the values in, E can be represented by ECS and ECCH, then you will find these values easily. Okay, and you know not to do that. You just write the equation and put in the that one, what is called MATLAB, and MATLAB will do it for you. You don't need to do anything. Okay, so it's not that much mental task. So 9, 10, 11 can be represented in this way. And similarly, 12, 13, 14, 12, 13, and 14 can be represented this way. Similarly, the repetition of same equation with different boundary values will be represented in this way. Okay, because what will be the I3 to I4, I14 here, I16, 6 to I20 will be represented here. So it will be the same way. So after calculating all these equations, this integration can be solved by hand, because there is a E here in E and log both is there inside this integration. So that is be solved by the Samson approximation method or any approximation method you can use there. Okay, but Samson approximation will give, when it is a give the interval of 16 to 20, and it will be the error rate is 0.009%. So it is very accurate. So you can use that one also. So, or any approximation method you can use. Okay, now where A is represented in there, this is the mainly some that one equation coefficients or something like that, the approximation where we have taken. So after that, the your FS, what is that, your source Fermi potential you have calculated, and then FCH you have to calculate. So this is the two basic equation you can find in the books also. In any semiconductor good book, you will find this equation. And then total drain current you can find in this way. Okay, now we have seen that ID proportional to I1 minus I2, but that is a constant term. When you replace this proportional to by the exact, find out the value, then you will find that this one, and the Planck's constant will be 0.9 and of your M0. M0 means absolute effective mass of the electron. So which is the Planck's constant. So in this way you can find the current. So it is a very once derivation is that much difficult, but difficult not, I have lengthy, but it will mentally very not that much stressful, and it is giving the good result. I'll show you. And for geodesic effect, what is happening? Earlier we have changed that the maximum tunneling length, we whatever we are getting from the previous conventional equation, we will not consider that. We will consider that one. So that is the one thing. And another thing, when we calculated, we see that there is a parallel shift. Parallel shift means when suppose one graph is there. I'm explaining the parallel shift. Suppose a graph is there. Okay. And one graph is there. So that is means that is a parallel shift of the graph. Okay, everywhere the difference is same. Okay, if this is there, so then we can use a fitting parameter here to minimize this thing. And you will getting the exactly same difference in each and every value of your potential. So that fitting parameter can be donated by this way. And using this fitting parameter, we will have found out the, if you find the fitting parameter for one point, you will find it for the everywhere. Okay, the same. So we have used this one and we are good to go for the result and of the result resolution section. Then this equation, we see that for the full gate, this is a good match of the surface potential already we have achieved. And drain current also here, we found that it's a good match. Earlier, I forgot to show one thing. That time, drain current model is actually dependent on A and B parameters. Let me show you. Go back and here, if you see that the drain current is mainly depend on this A and B value. These are the material dependent parameter. And when we change the material dependent parameter using that, then we see that it, when this part, you say that this part is material, when the subthreshold region is not that is that much good matching. But when we use the different type of A and B values, then it will give the good matching. Okay, so we need to adjust the A and B also. But where in this case, we found, we see that there's nothing like that. We got the good matching here also. Okay, full gate and our GOSA defect also. So these are the, this paper has been published in Journal of Computational Electronics. You can find in this using this. Okay, and previous paper, previous model technique, I forgot to mention that one. You can find that in the silicon analytical drain current model of the gate on source channel FYT. Okay, so these two, and so in this way you can calculate this drain current in these two method. And while give you simply the capacitance, how to do the capacitance model also. In capacitance, you will find, you have to find out the capacitance component. What are the capacitance component may be present in your devices, which will be significantly giving you the all the constituent the capacitance. Suppose if you over underlap is there, so there is a one fringing field capacitance will be there, overlap capacitance will be there, depletion region is there, so depletion region capacitance will be there. You know that if you draw a if it is a device, the inversion layer, because there is a depletion region will be there. So inversion layer actually is opposite in this here. In MOSFET, what we find out, the inversion layer actually formed in this way, and due to the saturation region here, it is inclined in this way. But in TFET, it is in the totally in opposite direction. Okay, so there is inversion layer component will be there, and that there the inner fringing field, inner gate fringing field also will be there. So by considering all the, okay, how to remove this? Okay. So if we consider this, so we need to find out this parameter. And by all the book, we have the means direct equations for this. And you can use directly, similarly use the surface potential, then derive the capacitance equation. Okay, because derivation means you directly use the equation. And this equation you can directly find out the any kind of standard book, and just combine this, and finally you will get if you use this equation, you combine the from the surface potential, take the all the inputs and find out the modeling of your capacitance model you will use for device. Obviously there needs to be some special notation you need to take, like the drain current model also. Here, suppose this is a depletion region capacitance, this is the inversion layer capacitance, how you calculate it. Okay, everything is there, and you can find also this in the micrometer letter paper. Okay, so in this way, so I think that's all from my side. And thank you everyone, patience listening for me. Actually, modeling is a little bit boring topic, but as much as information I can provide you in the simplest way, I have given that one. Now, if you have any question, I am happy to answer that.
Participants, if you have any questions, then please you can unmute yourself and ask your question, or you can inbox in the chat box itself. Okay, Suman sir, I guess there's no, there are no questions. And so the next in line, the session is, of course, the, as per the schedule, it's the demonstration, the hands-on session. And
okay,
so we can proceed with that.
Yes, ma'am, we can proceed with the hands-on session. And
Suman sir, your voice is really very, okay, there's a question. There's a question, I guess. Shubhangi Saxena has questioned that any method to find a fitting parameter. That is a question.
Okay. Finding perimeter fitting parameter is not robust technique. There is no robust technique or predefined technique is there. You can do one thing. When you derive your full model using the conventional equation, then you will get a one result. And you can check that what is the difference between your result and what is the actual result you want to search for. If you have the simulation layer result in your hand, then you will change the how much difference we are there or how much we need to achieve. Yeah, if you are doing a modeling and the fabrication, then you have the fabrication result. So there is a difference. So in difference, you need to figure out what are the parameters may be affecting these, which I may have missed in this our modeling process. So you need to incorporate that parameter in such a way that that will formulate a fitting parameter in your final model.
Okay, sir. So there is another question from Nelathuri Nagendra. He asked. You can see. Yeah, you can see in the chat box.
Yeah. Sir, for the gate overlap drain structure, can we use the same method like gate overlap on source? Yes, gate overlap already, what model I have shown you, that is the region one part I have shown you that there is a overlap section is there, that was this is generating overlapping capacitance. Similar section also there in that one drain current GOSC TFET model also, where you see that one section we have considered where the source section, because why it is a different section, because doping concentration will be different, material type will be different, so each and every section will not be uniform. Where the uniformity is there, it will be put in the one section. So that as the drain overlap is also there in this modeling, drain underlap is there and drain overlap also is there, and in the overlap section we mainly considering the Poisson equation and we'll good to go. But we need to figure out the what are the section we need to figure or form, how many section we need to form in our devices. By the we get the uniformity effect. This effect of the uniformity means gate effect, drain effect, doping concentration, materials. Each section, each box should be uniform. I think it will answer your query.
Any more questions, participants? Okay, there's another question, sir.
Sir, why do we use two gate at top and bottom? As I already said, top gate is mainly the controlling gate, or that will give you the device, the main current. But bottom gate, that is means you can say back gate or body. SY is not there, it is considered as the only body which is found in the four terminal MOSFET also. So when we SY consider, it is terminal will change, it is called a back gate, because if oxide is there, we call it a gate, one type of gate, but it's a back gate, but it's a negligible effect because oxide thickness is very high as compared to the main gate. So that gate give you the extra control of the device performance. As I show you that non-conventional effects like the trap or fixed oxide charges or temperature effect is there, that time your current, off current or amipolar current may be vary, or on current also you may be degraded in nature. So to minimize that degradation, you can use this bottom gate. Or else you don't have that much effect in this tunnel field direct transistor, the effect of the back gate. Okay, but it has the extra control when the non-conventional effects are there in your device. So it can give you the extra control of your device.
Okay, sir. So I hope there are no more questions. So we can proceed with the hands-on session, the demonstration part. So you can actually proceed.
So we'll have a short 5 minutes break to set up that demonstration, and then we'll start with the demonstration session.
Okay, so participants, you are requested to stay tuned. We'll be heading back again after 5 minutes, right? Okay, so we are on a break for 5 minutes, and then we'll be starting with our hands-on session. Thank you. And please fill up the feedback form. The link has been already shared in the chat box.
Hello participants, now we'll start the demonstration session, software demonstration session. So in this software demonstration session, we'll mainly discuss the Synopsys TCAD, one industrial simulation tool for the device semiconductor, which is been used by the Intel, Global Foundry, THMC. These are the foundries. Who actually manufacture the semiconductor devices or semiconductor ICs, semiconductor wafers, which used in the different circuitries. So that they are using these tools. So these are the best, very rigorous and very iterative methods using by these tools to generate your results. So results are almost perfect, you can say. Even in this simulation tools, you can use different nonlinearity equations also. So I think your the screen is visible. Everyone?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is visible.
Okay. Yes, sir. Visible.
Okay. This is a CentOS workbench. In CentOS, there is many modules are there. CentOS workbench is there. CentOS process is there. In different tool, you can achieve the different level of integrations or simulation. In these, we have the simplest way of doing the simulation, where we do the minimum ideal kind of simulation. If you want to do the more realistic kind of simulation, and which is doing by the different fabrication laboratories or that, they are mainly using the CentOS process. They also use the CentOS workbench. For initial layout, between the initial layout and initial result, they use the CentOS workbench. Then they use the CentOS process. So in this demonstration session, and followed
sir,
by the two more.
Sir, please speak a bit loud, please. Your voice is not very clear.
Okay, now it's clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what I'm saying, in this follow-up sessions also, which is scheduled in tomorrow and day after tomorrow also, we'll see that CentOS workbench only. And in this CentOS workbench, first let me today will not do the rigorous work. We'll just see the what are the components are there, what we can do from use this CentOS workbench, and how many tools are already there for the visualization and device manufacturing device simulation purposes. So if you say it's a Linux system. It's a client-based server client model software. So here in this software, we can directly see the in we just need to open a terminal and we need to write SWB and press enter, then it will open up the CentOS workbench. This is the CentOS workbench. Here all the everything you need you will get. So here there is a project section is there where you will can add new project, you can open your old project. When you will create a new project, then you will find that you can save this project also, but we'll go through this little one by one. Now in the edit section, you can delete on that one. Scheduler, it's not that much important. Main section is that what is the tools available here. So if you go to the add section, if you click on the tools, anyone if you want to have learn this software, I will suggest when we go step by step. We'll not do today step by step. We'll give you the overview. What are the possible tools are there? How can you use that one? And tomorrow we'll give you the thorough process of how to manufacture a device. How to create a device in this tool. And after tomorrow we'll give you the how to simulate and get the result of a device tool. Okay. Our device result from this software. So if you see this, there is a different as process where it will mainly use the fabrication related of inputs. like how much do you think that how much impurity will be there, how much gradient doping profile will be there, everything is there. So the ST process 3D and ST Pro is there. ST Pro 3D and ST Pro ST Pro is the for that layout creation. Suppose you have the device and you need to do with the layout profilization, then you can use these two. You can use SDE, Central Device Editor. You can use this tool for doing the or preparing any device. We'll mainly use this tool for our analyze purpose. Thus, this device this also do the interconnecting part, the metallization and interconnecting IC fabrication. What we'll use that connection can be do from this tool. This is the S device. S device we use for the simulation purpose, where we need to generate our devices and that. Okay. And these are the new tools which we don't have that for yet. By the we see that where the cornering effect, you know, the cornering effect, that the electric field accumulation is there. So all the electromagnetic waveforms, or what is the that what is called that internal electric field, how this affecting your device, it will be destroyed, or how much electromagnetic interference will be there, that can be observed from there. And there is a as visual and inspect, these two tools. That is also for the visualization purpose. So we'll mainly use as device for the device preparation. We'll use the central device editor for device preparation, S device for simulate the device, to give the all the physics files, all the necessary information to simulate the device. Like our, if we need to simulate a device, for what voltage range, -1 to +3, -0.5 to +2, what will be the gate voltage, what will be the drain voltage, what physics file you need to incorporate in the simulation, what type of what is called physics parameter, like a temperature, interface trap, fixed offset charge, how you will describe in that, you will find is this, or you can incorporate all these physics and electrode or electro potential related information in this file. Even that one, what is called, even some material related information also already in this tool, already we'll see that the different materials are already available. If we see that SDE tool, I have already opened that one. SDE means central structure editor. This is central structure editor looks like. Yes. So it's look like looks like this. You see that different materials are already there. If you can see that the molybdenum, nickel, tungsten oxide, polysilicon, many, so many materials already, the recent raised materials, all are already predefined here. Even you can add your own material here also. Okay. So here it is like a on almost a paint window. Okay. You just need to suppose you have a applicate and draw, you need to, what type of device you need to do. If you want to draw a device, then how you want to achieve that? The rectangular, you need a polygonal or circular or electrical, what type of region you need to do. So with whatever you select, according to that, that section will be created. And if you see that one, you see that is a different view. You see, this is a silicon thin film has been created, and we don't know the dimension. For check the dimension, we need to click that exact coordinate. We'll give the step by step demonstration tomorrow, but we'll give the now I am giving the only overview. So when we'll exact coordinate, then when you will click to draw anything, you'll ask for the coordinate. So coordinate means now you have some values. Okay, now you can't this is like, this is the previous one is a random. We don't know what is the length, what is the value. Okay, but now if we suppose we need to draw a, or we need to fabricate a 100 nanometer length, 30 nanometer height, silicon thickness body. So we'll see zero, and here it will be zero. Second vertex will be have the will take the diagonals only, and all the values we are mentioning that is in the micrometer region. So for the nanometer we have to use 0.something. If we give, so it is first vertex is 0. Suppose this is a silicon film, and if we think about that, suppose this region, if you go using the coordinate system, this system, this point is 0.0, and if it is 100 nanometer long, that your second push point will be your 0, 100 nanometer long will be 0.1 micrometer, and if your thickness is that 30 nanometer thickness is there, then this point will be 0.03, 30 nanometer means 0.03 micrometer, and this corner will be 0. Okay, so what we are saying that this width is 30 nanometer and your length is 100 nanometer. That means that coordinate system, if we draw the coordinate according to the coordinate system, so if this corner is 0.0, then if we increase, if y is positive direction is lower side and that is in the right side, okay, so it will be become 0.0, and it will become the, if we apply the coordinate system 0.03, this corner will be 0.10, and this will be 0.1 comma 0.03. Yes, so we can, when we are drawing anything in here, then we'll simply take the vertex. Vertex means if any, we can you cross any diagonal, so that end to coordinate, if we place a one line here, that if the end coordinate, this end to coordinate we can use, or if you, or we can use these two coordinates, that there will be one line. So software will, what will do, so what you will do, when it will, you will give this one, so it will calculate these two points, and it will find out that they the software user want to manufacture or produce or create a rectangular region, then it will be the, must be the height of this length will be 3, because y value is 0.3 and x value is 0.1, means 100 nanometers you want to create a length. So then it will form the, this type of region. If we go to the same, and if we press this one, okay. let me draw again. अच्छा लगेगा। Participants, there is an internet discontinuity. Please wait. We are resuming your demonstration session.
Suman sir.
Yes, ma'am.
There's a question a participant has till then if you can actually see his
Is it advantageous over Silvaco Atlas? There is a different simulators are there, different companies are there who are it is not like that there is a which one is better, this is Samsung is better or your MI is better. It's not nothing like that. You can do every work in every simulator, but if you think about the critical conditions, I will suggest if you are working in the homogeneous material, means in the single or not that much multiple layers or different material layers are there, then you can use TFET, MOSFET, FinFET. You can better to use synopsis ticket. And if you are using for the heterogeneous device like HAMT, where there's the ELGAN, GAN, different layers are there, almost 6 to 7 layers are there. So for that cases, I will suggest you can use Silvaco Atlas. Either way, you can use both. Any of them. There's nothing like that. It is superior to another one. Silvaco and Synopsys, both are well accepted. Or the results generated by from this software, you can accept. It is accepted in each and everywhere. Okay, there's no issue. Yes, for the TFET MOSFET structure meshing or tunneling zone need to be defined here. Yes, obviously without meshing, you can't do anything because meshing is the basic parameter of your simulation where this each meshing size, that means each mesh can be defined for your all the simulation of your numerical or physics files will be simulated for the each and every small portion. Meshing means you dividing your total device into small portion, and each small portion iteration will iterative way it will solve the your physics file. So meshing obviously is required, and as much as higher meshing is better for the best result, most accurate result. Okay, I will be getting disconnected for 2 to 3 minutes because I'm trying to resume my connection on the fourth laptop. हेलो मैंने कहा, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल बट प्लीज बी
ठीक है,
लाउडर.
ओके.
या योर माइक इज लाइक दिस.
स्किन इज विजिबल मैम?
इट्स गोइंग टू बी विजिबल. वॉइस इज क्लियर. गुड, द
ओके
वॉइस इज
ओके,
क्लियर. या इट्स गोइंग टू बी विजिबल नाउ. इट्स यू अगेन लॉग आउट आई गेस.
ओके ओके. बट तो सो व्हाट आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड द सिमिलर थिंग. इफ वी सो इफ वी चेक द एग्जैक्ट कोऑर्डिनेट एंड वी क्रिएट द 2D 1 to 2D रेक्टेंगुलर रीजन, देन वी जस्ट नीड टू राइट लेफ्ट क्लिक एंड ड्रैग. एंड एज वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दैट दिस वर्टेक्स विल 0 0, and the another vertex which is already we have here discussed 0.1 and 0.03. So 0.1 will be here, another vertex, and 0.03. So it will create a your what is called silicon region, and that region, so it is look like this one. Okay, so it is created a silicon region. Okay, now it this is, so in this way you can use different material region here. You can use different material regions here. Okay, and from so this is the one tool. Another tool is the S device. Let me we'll mainly demonstrate you the SDE, CentOS device editor. The S device for the simulation, for the visualization purpose we use S visual and Inspire. These four tool will give you the basic idea on that. Okay. So when you will add the tool, it will look like this. Okay. If you want to add another tool, just go to add tool and you want to suppose add this one. This is a simulation file. So in this, you can right click on this, go to the edit input and command. You can write your command also. If you write your command here, then you can simulate using this command directly. You can just want to save that and go and run, then your device will be ready if you know the direct command. In S device, you can write your command here, and from there up here also you can see that what are the files you have added, and you need to just save it and run here. And the similar way, you need to go to the edit input and you need to add the parameter file here. In the parameter file, you need to add the base material, silicon or other material you want to choose. If it is silicon based device, that silicon is by default selected. Or other materials, you need to add other materials also. First, you if you use a silicon based device, first use the silicon. Then you, after adding the silicon, you choose other materials also. Okay, so first you will choose silicon, then see. Instantly the silicon file has been picked out, means the silicon.pr, pr means parameter file. So all the parameters of silicon materials are already available there. So it will call that file for your simulation. And then if you want to use another parameter, other materials you want to include, then you can go there after silicon. Or if it is not a silicon based, then directly you can use that one. Then you can use anything. If suppose if you use HFA2, then you just click that on HFA2. Then you have used suppose gallium arsenide in your device, then use gallium arsenide. Suppose if you use platinum as a your metal, use this one and just click OK. When you click OK, you see that all the four thing is by defaultly called when your device will simulate. Okay, so this is the S device. And in S device, what will be the codes you need to write? I will give you the brief introduction in tomorrow. And now see how to visualize anything. So in the extension, you will find each and every tool: the Centros structure editor, Centros process editor, Centros visual. Okay. As device, you can directly add from the tool only here, where you will write the physics file. And in the extension, you can device editor. If you click the device editor, you will have this window. And here you can draw the device. You can this mesh, what one participant is asking about the meshing, you can do the window wise section. Then you can that refinement placement means you can give small boxes inside that window. You can divide in the source, drain, channel region. Suppose you have the source region window, keep very small window, then it will find it here. And in device section, draw section, you will draw the material, you will add the material. Mesh means you will part your devices in small section. And after mesh, you have the device. In device section, you will actually add the doping of what type of doping material you want to use. You want to formulate a N-type material, you want to formulate a P-type material. That can be done for the device section, constant profile placement. So if you click that one, you will say that the constant profile, the what type, the boron, arsenic is other also there. Your, how much concentration will be there, which window, when you will divide the value window, that will be discussed. So you can use the concentration, doping concentration from this. And finally, you can use, if you want to formulate a fabricated device, obviously contact is required. Without contact, you can't give any potential or electrostatic input, electric input. So if for the electric input, you need contact. So you can set the contact, gate contact, drain contact, body contact, all the contacts you can set from here. So you want the contact set, you can form, first you will formulate here. So suppose your source, so it will source contact, it is set, then you will need to activate it for use in the this window. So after that, when you suppose body, you know, so source will be in the edge, so you will select the edge, you will click on that, sorry, you need to set that arrow for selection, click on that and right click, you see the contact, you can add source, means what contact I have written, that can be added directly here. So it will act as a source contact. If you have another contact, you can write here and it will be contact. If it is a drain contact, that the drain will be there. If it is source contact, so it will be again source, both sides is source now. So it will look like that. Then after that, one important parameter is there. You see that overlapping behavior. You see that two file here is overlap each other. Now, what is the overlapping behavior? Suppose you have suppose you have this box, and above this box you want to add this circle. So now what you are looking, this side is from the rectangular portion and this whole thing is from the elliptical portion. So this side will be behave as a rectangular box, and this side, this full section will be elliptical box. That means it is replacing new, replacing old. The old portion, where it is old portion and new portion of wallet is there, it is behave as a new property only. If you want to bring it back, send backward, then what will happen? Now, what you are seeing? Now you are seeing that it is added later part, but old replaces new. Means where the overlap is there, old portion is replacing the new portion. The same thing is also available here. So here, you see that overlap behavior, new replace old replace new overlap old. Means both are available, but one above another. Okay. So in this way, you need to check the overlap behavior also. So exact coordinate is one point. 2D create tool, what you require, 2D or 3D create tool, like suppose you want to get sphere. Okay, so you will have a sphere. It is a sphere. You will have a that time kind of sphere. Okay, suppose you want to add a cylinder. So you have a cylinder, okay? If you this, see, you have a cylinder now, okay? So what you are, and everything your vertex will be asked. Whatever you put the vertex, it will be drawn. So first drawing part is over, minimum basic what you need to know. Then mesh for the small window, device for the doping concepts, contact for the setting the contact. That's all for the device structure editor. Now, if you want to check from the extension tool, structure editor is the process. Okay, process currently is not activated in my device. Centros visual. It will take little bit time for the opening of Centros visual. And Centros is yes, this is the Centros visual window. Okay, when you open any para the inspect window, we'll discuss it later. Suppose any when this is a simulated model already simulated. So when there is a plot file TDS size there, plot file, when you will have the plot file, you will have directly suppose gate voltage versus drain current you want to see. So directly you will have this kind of graph. Okay, directly you will have this kind of graph. You can see the logarithm portion also. Okay, you want to zoom it, you can zoom it from here. Okay, so it is a very simple thing to notice. And there is a TDR files also will be there. Band.tdr, dash.tdr, mesh.tdr. What file XML, which file give you the which benefit, we'll discuss about that. Okay, so these are the TDR files. These are the mainly doping concentration is actually showing currently. Okay, so there is a different TDR files are there also. Okay, here is the dash dot TDR file. You will see that absolute electric field, acceptor concentration, band gap narrowing, everything you can see from this file. Okay, so how to simulate that, this figure, we'll also discuss that one. So that's all from the as device and inspect. Finally, in the inspect you can similarly this one you can use only plot file, and using that plot you can actually calculate all the other things. How? Suppose you go to the screen, you want to know the VT of this car. Okay. I think it is not really. Okay. This is GM. You then see that GM value is showing here. That is the GM value. Okay, so GM value is showing there. So we can calculate directly from inspection. If you want to ask, suppose it is, if you want to want the minimum current, so minimum, I think, no, that is the DEC mean, DEC mean, DEC mean, yeah. Then you will find out the minimum current value of this curve. So in that way, you can analyze anything or IDVG curve in different way from this inspect tool. So that's all for, I think, today. We'll give you the total demonstration or one by one demonstration. Today, I have given the overview of the FISH tool. SDE, Centros Device Editor, as visual. How the SDB SD can be used using the direct code and using the graphical tool also. As device for the coding, how can you write the or where you can write the physics file, how you can add the different parameter files, and the S device for how you visualize all your parameters, output, electric field, surface potential, vent to vent generation, anything. And after that, if you want to analyze anything from the IDBG characteristics, where you will do that, that is inspect. This four tool will discuss one by one. And tomorrow we'll mainly see that how we can generate a MOSFET kind of thing, or MOSFET, basic MOSFET we'll take, and we'll check the central device structure to how we can generate or create a MOSFET in this structure, and we'll see that how it will look like. Okay, so tomorrow we'll discuss the SDE, and day after tomorrow we'll discuss the S device and all the visualization aspects. Okay.
Okay. Suman sir, there are certain questions, two or three questions. There's a question from Amit Bhattacharya. If you can see in the chat box, or I should dictate it. He asked that in the succeeding classes, will you show noise related issue like noise power spectral density, drain current spectral density?
Pardon, ma'am. Sorry, echo was there. Can you repeat, ma'am? Or you
can
the
write question it, is the question the is. The question is, in the succeeding classes, will you show noise related issue like noise power spectral density and drain current spectral density?
Noise power spectral density we have not included in this one. Maybe we'll have the different FDP session for the RF and noise analysis, all other things. In this one, basically, we'll discuss about the drain current, capacitance, how. What are the models you can use? We mainly give you the software, how to use this software. Okay. And we'll not specifically use that one. If you want to know the directly power spectral density related to power spectral density, in the fourth day, fifth day, the last session, we may include that one also, if you want that. Power spectral density, we'll think about that one. Okay.
I hope the question has been answered. Last question we have, a question is from Saurabh Jaiswal. I think it's a software-based question. He asked that the text command window appearing below the structure editor is lost. How come I can get it? I mean, I guess it is a software-based question.
Actually, if he is there, he can unmute himself.
He can elaborate. Saurabh
Jaiswal. Yes, sir. Yes, I am there, sir.
Yes, sir. Can you tell me?
Yes,
hey,
you can put your question, please.
Sir, actually, I was doing some hands-on there. So, in the structure editor, I certainly opened the CentOS structure editor, and there I have seen that the bottom window, which is appearing as a commands, it has been lost there. It is not showing there. So, I was willing how to get it there from there.
You are talking about this section?
Yes, sir. Instruction. That we will be taking from the bottom of, yes, sir. Scheme command that are mentioning there. Yes, you are clicking at that side, correct?
I actually, that problem never happened to me, but I think that is a view option is there. Here you see that. Okay. From that UI, you can see the GU mode. We can check that one and I can give you the response.
Please check at your end, because I have tried to get it off that, but I am unable to get it. Okay. If there is any option, please okay. Provide me.
Okay. I will check today and I will inform you tomorrow. Okay. Because that problem never occurred with me.
Sure. We'll be waiting, sir, for that, for the same.
Okay. Okay, I will give you the answer tomorrow.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay. Any more questions, participants? Any more questions regarding today's session?
Amit Bhattacharya is saying, thanks a lot, sir. If possible, then try to arrange on fifth day. I will be grateful.
I think
power spectral density. Okay, we'll try to incorporate that one also.
Okay. Fine. So, I guess there are no more questions. Tomorrow we'll be meeting again on the day 3rd at 10 a.m. As per the schedule has been already shared to you, and we'll be meeting at 10 a.m. We'll be having a lecture on, and then we'll be proceeding in the second half with the demonstration 2, right? So thank you all. So can we just stop with the all the
okay,
I'll, fine.
Just
so thank you all for joining. We'll meet tomorrow at 10 a.m. Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for participating. And everyone, please do fill up the Google form.